Praise the Lord. I welcome you for this morning devotion. Today is the fifth Sunday after Easter and the third Sunday of this month. And today's scripture portion which we have taken is from John chapter 14 verses 15 to 21. And the another scripture is taken from John chapter 20 verses 19 to 22. And the theme of today's is receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. Easter is over, but Jesus has not yet ascended. And the disciples knew that he would be leaving soon. Jesus had been their teacher, their guider, their mentor, but he would not be there with his disciples. Just after the resurrection, the disciples had locked themselves inside the room, being afraid of Jew and also afraid of their own shadows. This all happened on the first day of the week of crucifixion. And in midst of that room, the locked room, Jesus stood before them and said, "Peace be with you." He said, "Peace be with you. As Father has sent me, so I sent you. As Father had sent me, so I sent you." John chapter 20, verse 21. Further, Jesus said to them, He breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit." John 20:22. When I was reading this both the passage, I was amazed on a particular verse, the verse which says, why Jesus breathed on the disciple? Why he breathed? The reason which I got is Jesus wanted to know the disciple to understand what was going to happen in their upcoming life. And the breath means life. In Genesis chapter 2 verse 7, if we see, God created man with the soil and he breathed the life into him. And Jesus now is giving the same breath of life, but that too in a spiritual life. Here it is covered with both the life. One, the life of the world, and also the life to communicate with God. That is spiritual life. This he gave because he knew the tendency of the human being. And also his disciple. As we see in Matthew chapter 17 verse 16 to 19, if we read these verses, we understand that Jesus healed a boy who was possessed by the demon. And when the boy was brought to Jesus, first it was taken to the disciples, but the disciples were unable to heal him. And afterwards, they were brought to Jesus. And the father of the boy said to him, to Jesus, that your disciples are unable to him, so I brought this child to you. And Jesus answered them, "How unbelieving and wrong you people are. How long must I stay with you?" When we read this thing, it clearly recognizes that the disciples were unable to know what power did they have. They were not able to understand the power which is inside them. So Jesus wanted them and them to know that they have certain power, and the power which can be healing to others. And that's why we see he blew the breath on them. Through that power, the disciple would go to preach the word, to teach the word, and to heal. and that power is Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is an energy, a power, or a small voice, sometimes heard by us when we are in times of trouble. This energy is called as Holy Spirit, which guides us as a light in the darkness. As Psalmist David in his Psalms rightly says, Psalms 23 verse 4, it rightly says, "Even if I go through the deepest darkness, I will not be afraid, Lord, for you are with me, your shepherd staff are protecting me." See, David clearly says that you are with me when I am in the deepest darkness, and your staff will protect me. Why it will protect me? Because we are his children. And St. Paul rightly says in Ephesians chapter 4 verse 30 that the Spirit is God's mark on our God's mark of ownership. We have a mark of ownership on us through the Spirit. So each one of us belongs to God, and all we are here the children of God. And so he blew the Holy Spirit on us. Most of us, and most of the time, we would have experienced the Holy Spirit. It may be in times of trouble, depression, or in sick, or in any other condition. And at a particular point or a particular moment, we get relief by something or someone or some words. That is by the power of the Spirit. And Jesus said to us also in John chapter 14 verse 18, I will not leave you as orphan. He will not leave us as an orphan, but send us a helper. And that's why we see in John chapter 14 verse 16, Jesus said to us that, "I will give you another helper who will stay with you and for with you forever." He will send a helper who will stay with us forever and ever. So Jesus blew the breath and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit." In this lockdown situation of COVID-19, God is sending His Holy Spirit to us and saying, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Wherever you are in this, just receive the Holy Spirit. If you are in our home, if you are traveling, if you are alone," He's saying us to receive the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit will be with you forever and ever. Are we ready to receive that Holy Spirit? Let us pray and ask God to send that Holy Spirit to us. Let us pray. Lord of Wonder, we thank you, we praise you, Lord, for this wonderful time once again given to us, Lord. Lord, as your word says, receive the Holy Spirit. Yes, Lord, we ask the Holy Spirit, Lord. Let you send your Holy Spirit to us so that it can guide us, it can help us, and it can bless us. Yes, thank you, Lord. Lord, today we pray for all those who are working in the COVID-19 areas, Lord. Especially our brothers who are doctors, nurses, police department, and in others, staff workers too, Lord. Lord, let your presence and protection be upon them. Help them, guide them, and bless them, Lord. Use them for your glory. Remove all the hindrances of their life, Lord. Lord, we also pray for the people who are affected by this COVID-19, Lord. Let your healing hand be upon them. Touch them and heal them. Lord, we also pray for those who have lost their life through this COVID-19. Let you touch their family to our Lord and bless their family to our Lord. Yes, thank you, Lord. Lord, we especially pray and submit our church in your mighty hand. Let your presence and protection be upon our church and bless our church, O Lord. Lord, we give you honor and ask your spirit to be upon us forever. And in that belief, we pray and submit our request in your mighty hand and ask this prayer in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us all say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil. For thy is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of our God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide on all those who are here, on their family, now and forevermore. Amen.